In this video, I will teach you how to create a portfolio section using the Elementor Tabs feature. Hey guys, how are you? This is Michaela from Simplifying Websites. For those who haven't seen it, Elementor recently released an update to the Tabs feature, which allows us to create models inside it. And I'm going to show you that. First, I'm asking you to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Okay? So that's it. Let's go to my computer screen now. So, let's go, guys. I'm here on the MacCreative website, which is a portfolio website that I taught you to create here on the channel, okay? And for those who haven't seen it, I'll leave the link in the card and in the description if you want to go there and learn, okay? And then here in this video, I taught you to do this portfolio section, right? That we used the HTMega plugin, and we used it in this image scroll feature and also in the tabs feature. But it turns out that Elementor, from update 3.10, Elementor Pro, already has the tabs feature to be used with containers. So for those who saw how we created this section here, remember that we needed to make several models. So for example, I created a model to be the all, and then I came and called it here, right? I created a model called land pages, and then I clicked on this button here. And then with Elementor, we don't need to do this whole thing anymore, have all this work of creating several templates and calling them here. We can create everything directly here on the screen. That's what I'm going to teach you, okay? First, you have to make sure that your Elementor is in the correct version. So you have to come here in Plugins, Plugins Installed. See if the Elementor is from version 3.10, or mine was 3.8. I'll update to 3.12.1. Remembering that every time you update a plugin, it's good for you to come here, right? In the plugin, Awinion WP Migrator and do a backup. There's a video here on the channel teaching you how to do a backup, okay? Because if there's a problem, you go back to the previous version website, okay? Another thing you have to make sure is working is if your Flexbox containers is active, because this tabs function only works if the Elementor is in the Flexbox container version, okay? Which is the new technology. I'm going to pass the mouse here, go to settings, go to resources. Flexbox container is active, okay? I made this website with Flexbox container, so it's already active. Okay, I'll even reload this page so we can see it working. So you will access your Elementor editor on the page you want. And then you will come here. You will get the tabs or tabs widget. This one right here. I'm gonna drag it over here. Look, see? It's not working yet. I forgot to activate another thing, which is the animated widget feature. Here, animated elements. We have to come here and leave it active. And save. Now let me reload the page again. Done. I'm going to choose here. I'm going to come here. I'm going to get the tabs widget. This one. Look, now you see? It has a container in here. We don't need to do all that work we had before. We just come here and give the names, like for example. I'm going to put the first one here called all. This second tab, I'm going to put launching pages. This third one, I'm going to call stores, using the same buttons that are there. I'm going to duplicate it, and I'm going to call the last one institutional sites. Okay. I'm just going to show you how to zoom in here, which is this widget here, you see, of image scroll. For it, there is no Elementor, so we have to keep using the HTML plugin, okay? So for those who don't know, plugins, new add-ons. Come here, look for HTML. This plugin here, you will install and activate. And then, you will come here in the library. And you will have this image scroll widget here, which is this one, you see? It has the arrow up and down. Then you can drag it here, look, you see? Drag it here. For those who don't know, to take the print here from the whole screen like this, you do it like this. I'll even do it with a new one that I launched these days that I hadn't put here yet, right? Here, the home accounting launch page, which is a service launch page. That I did with Elementor Free, too. First you do this, okay? Recharge the whole page to make sure it loaded all the widgets here. Then do you see this little camera up there on the browser? I can have it with the Go Full Page Screen Capture extension. You come to Google, type Go Full Page Screen Capture. Chrome extension, right? It's usually the first one. You can click and activate it on your browser. Then, if it's not showing up here, you will click on this little puzzle icon, and it will leave its pin blue. Then it will appear here. Then, just click, and it will take a picture of the whole screen. Then you come here, click to download the image. But you won't upload this image here, neither with this name nor this size, okay? So you will come here to the I Love Image website, which is a website for you to be able to convert, resize, do several things with the image. There's a video just about it here on the channel. It's pretty cool. Then you will drag your image here. You can drag them all at once, okay? If you've already taken a print of several, drag it here. And then here you will put an adequate width. I'm going to put about 400 width, so it's still bigger than the size we're going to use, but then it doesn't get too blurry. I put 400 width and it's already readjusted here, see? Then you will resize and then you will download. If it doesn't download automatically, you click here on download, okay? Okay, then you will upload the image here, okay? Then you come and drag the image here. Then, when it goes up here in title, you can go to the title, which is cool for SEO, so I can put it like this. LPH account. Put the name you want there, okay? But don't leave that ugly, unfriendly name there. Clicking on select, okay. Then here, as it's in the container, right? For us to make them face each other, I'm going to click here on the container inside. I'm going to leave it like this, horizontal. Then I'm going to come here. I'm going to duplicate it. I want it to be, how many are there? 3. I want it to be 3. Then I'm going to come here, on each of them. First, here in image size, I'm going to leave it full so it doesn't get blurry. Now I'm going to come here in advanced. I'm going to come here in width. I'm going to put custom width. No, there's one thing missing first. Here in the container, I'm going to come here. I'm going to leave it in space between the elements. I'm going to leave it in percentage. I'm going to leave it 2%, right? Which is to have 2% of spacing. And then we have, look, two spaces that we're leaving here. We have two spaces that we're using here, see? If each one has 2%, we're using 2, 4, right? We're using 4% only with these gaps here. So of 100% of the space, we're using 2 for spacing. So there's 96 left for us to work. This divided by 3, each of the boxes has to be 32% wide. So we come here in advanced width. I leave it here in percentage, and I'm going to put 32, see? Then I'm going to copy, paste the style, and paste the style, see? Then it got too high. I'm going to come here, turn it into content, so we can adjust the height here, see? Height. Then we decrease. Let me see how much I left in these here. Oh, you can't see it, right? I'm going to do an average here. You can put as much as you want. Leave about 300 height. Okay, it's already a nice size. We can click the copy button and paste the style here in the others. So, this other way I taught you, putting a button down here if you want, you would have to do it in a slightly more complicated way, which is, for example, let me show you here in this container here, right? You would have to take a container here, duplicate it to get 3, see? As if it were 3 columns. Then you would take it, put an image here, in this case here, it would have to be 100%, put an image here and a button here. So we would have to have 3 containers inside of one. Then I found a way here that is better, that we save code and we can also put the button. I'm going to delete this here. Let it be. We do it like this. We come here in it, in the widget, and it has the link here, right? It has a link here that we can put. So I'm going to put the link here of this landing page, which is this one, home account. I'll put it here. Remember to always leave the images complete so as not to get blurry. See, the others are blurry. This one here, now that I've put it all, isn't it? Okay, I put the link here, right? You can leave this active here to open another window so it doesn't leave the site. You see what's here, budget? You click here and an item appears for you to put a title. It's not a button, it's just a title. So, for example, here I'm gonna write, just like the button up there, see? Ver Projeto. So I'm going to put the link here. Ver Projeto Online. See? So what can I do? Ver Projeto Online, for example. This link we put is for the entire image, see? Anywhere I click on the image will have a link. But since we put this little button here, the person will think it's a button. So it will be directed to click here on the button, right? And then, as anywhere it can click, it will click here and go to this link, see? And then we come here in style, in budget, we will have the settings here that we can do with it, right? Here in offset, we can click and organize where we want it to be, see? We can leave it right here in the center. And here, we go down here, see? So we position it wherever we want it to be. And then we can change the colors too. So the background type, I'll click here. Since I already have colors here, I'll click and get the pink color. And here in color, I will choose the white color, see? And down here, we can configure the typography. I'll just put a capital transformation here, see? It already looks like the one up there. Then you adjust it here, and it gets a little crooked. You adjust it, leaving it where you want it to be, and then there's a little button here, see? And then it's already like this, see? There's a little button here, okay? and then you can configure the same thing in the others. Then, in all the others, you put this little button, right? Activate it here, put the title here, see project online, and up here you put the link, okay? I'm going to cut to the part that I already... By the way, let me just teach you how to do something here. Look, if I duplicate this here, it won't break the line, because we need to come here in the container and leave it wrapped, right? Then yes, it broke the line, see? So, depending on how much you put, how many lines you put, you have to come here in the container at minimum height and increase the height so that they come off here, see? See? And now yes, it's a nice space. They came off here one from the other, okay? Then you do this duplicate. I'll skip to the part here that I've already changed all the images. I'm here on institutional sites, right? So, I'm going to put the institutional sites here, which, in this case, are here in the ones I made. So, these three, I'm going to put a fourth, which, for those who haven't seen it, has this website here, very cool, from the channel of Innovar e Nutri, which is a website that I taught you to create with Elementor free. It's really cool. I'll put it too. I'm going to cut to the part that I've already put all the institutional sites there. Look, I put the three institutional sites here. And before we get this container to be able to replicate in the others, right? Because we're going to do this, we're going to take advantage of the settings, we're just going to finish setting up for mobile. So I'm going to click here. I'll leave it here on the phone, and I realize that it's on the side of the other. We're going to come here, we're going to come to advanced, leave it at a total width of 100, right? And then we're going to come here in style, we're going to come here in budget, we're going to come in offset, and we're going to leave it here more in the middle, right? Then, just click on copy, right-click paste style, on the other, right-click paste style. You see? Here it's stuck to the other one because the height is not enough. We come, increase this height a little more. Look, now it's already detached. You see? So it's already cool. Look, I can put it here on the desktop. Then I'll click on it here, I'll copy. Then, for example, I'll come here in stores and I'll click here on paste. Then I can duplicate, duplicate. Then I come here. I can't come here in this container and copy its settings, right? So, here in these other containers, I'll have to do it anyway. So I come here, right? We have to come here in space, leave it in percentage, leave it 2%. We have to come here in involve and leave it in line break, and we have to come here in direction and leave it horizontal, right? It's the configuration we have to do for everyone here, right? So I come here in this one, I already make these settings. Look. I already have horizontal, line break, spacing, percentage, 2%, and I come here and paste the boxes. Look, I can duplicate, and they are already right here, right? Remembering that when there is more than one line, right? And it's getting messy. I have to come here in the container. Minimum height and increase height, so they don't get stuck. So I'll finish doing it. I'll come here in stores. I'll change the images and links, right? Remembering that the image here and the link here. And I'll come here in launch page too. I'll change the images and links, and I'll come here in all, and I'll put all the images and all the links. Done, I've already put them all. So I put these four on the institutional site. Look, they are all institutional sites that I taught here on the channel. All these four stores here. Launch page, I also put four, and here in all, I put all, right? Then it was the 12. 12 is great, right? It was the 12. Look, guys, 12 projects of which I've already taught on the channel. This is not all, right? It's half. I've already taught about 20 or 20 and a few on the channel. And look, if you do all these projects, you already have a portfolio with 12. Which is a lot, right? More than 90% of people have it in their portfolio, right? Usually people don't even make a portfolio or put anything, so if you make yours, you're ahead of everyone, right? Just give it another check. Click here, put it in the mobile, on the tablet, check if everything is right. And look, it's cute, it's functional. If you also want to round the buttons here, there's a way. You come here in style, then here on the tabs you will have to round. You see? You can put, for example, 30 of padding, and they are already rounded, the colors, right? So the type of background you can configure here, in the hover, which is the action of passing the mouse, you configure it here. Here, the padding, which is the spacing inside so you can configure it, or if you want it to be thinner, you can put, for example, 5, then you unlink the values, and only here on the right and on the left you put 15, look. And then it gets thin, and only like that with the bigger sides. You see? It looks cool too, but that other way is also really cool. I would even leave it the original way, square or rounded. It's also very interesting. Okay, guys, that's it. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, activate the bell, a hug. See you next time. Bye.